I'm Vanilla. In today's video, I'm going to talk about capacitance. Let us take two conductive plates and keep them separated by a distance. These plates are electrically neutral, or in other words, they have an equal number of positive and negative charges. Now let's connect the battery. Even though they are conductive plates, the electrons cannot flow through them because they don't have any physical contact. But another interesting process happens when we connect the battery. We know that battery has a positive end and a negative end. Once the battery is connected, the negative charges on this plate are attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery. And from the negative terminal, negative charges are repelled. As the negative charges leave this plate, it becomes positively charged. Similarly, this plate becomes negatively charged. It is important to notice that both plates will have the same magnitude of charges. Even if we remove the battery, the charges will remain on the plate. Therefore, we can say that these plates are storing electrical charges. This ability of a component to collect and store energy in the form of an electric charge is called capacitance. A capacitor is a device that consists of two conductor plates separated by a dielectric medium. What is a dielectric medium? It can be any insulator or even air. Now, let's come back to our illustration. As we see, the negative charge accumulates in one plate and the equal amount of positive charge accumulates in the next plate. Technically, this accumulation process is known as charging. This process cannot continue forever. There is one point when the plate can no longer collect charges. That is the point that we say that the capacitor is fully charged. The amount of charge a capacitor can store depends on the capacitance value. The capacitance of a capacitor can be increased by increasing the area of the plates or decreasing the distance between the plates. Placing an insulator between the plates also increases the capacitance value. Capacitance is expressed as a ratio of the electric charge on each conductor to the potential difference between them. Capacitance is measured in farads, named after an English physicist, Michael Faraday. A farad is a large quantity of capacitance. Most capacitors are measured in a smaller quantities such as microfarad, nanofarad and picofarad. On the other hand, supercapacitors can store huge electrical charges of thousands of farads. We have DC and AC supply. When a DC supply is applied across a capacitor, it starts charging. Once a capacitor is fully charged, the current doesn't flow, and the circuit will act like an open circuit. That's why, while doing the steady state DC circuit analysis calculations, we always consider capacitor as an open circuit. When an AC supply is applied across a capacitor, it charges and discharges continuously. This behavior causes the current to lead the voltage by 90 degrees. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.